Hey guys, it's Jesse from FPSSquared.com, and welcome to The Division. I'm a little late getting this video out, I realize that. This game's been out for about a week now. It's The Division. If you played the beta, then you've got the main gist of what the game is about. Some kind of super bug version of smallpox was released on Black Friday. And now New York is kind of a half-apocalyptic wasteland. I don't want to say it's completely post-apocalyptic because there's still a bit of a infrastructure and a government, kind of, and you're part of the police force that now monitors and protects, I guess, citizens of New York or something, called the Division. And that's basically the gist of the entire narrative. You're a member of this police force called the Division. Anyway, let's go in here and check out the headquarters of the game, which is where you're going to be spending a lot of your time. The game kind of revolves around these three wings that you see here. You see my medical wing is at 20%, my security wing is at 20%. The security wing was the one that wasn't in the beta. So, again, if you played the beta, you know what the medical wing and the tech wing are. The security wing wasn't in the beta, but basically, it's the same thing. It gives you the ability to get more perks and talents and stuff that weren't available in the beta. But like I was saying, the game revolves around these three wings here: your medical, your tech, and your security wing. If we actually get up through here, I hate that it makes you walk through that shit. But if we actually get up here, you can see that the medical wing's over here. You know, this is probably the first mission that a lot of people are going to do. It was the first mission I did. Of course, it's not the first mission you have to do. You can unlock any of these wings in any order that you want to. But yeah, here's the medical wing. You get on here and you can upgrade it with all these different things. And as you can see, when you upgrade, if you look over on the right, you get skills and perks and sometimes talents. And I'll explain what those are in a second. They're basically just character upgrades, but I'll kind of explain them in depth and specifically what they are in this game. But yeah, each wing has some upgrades that you can get, like you saw back there. And as you upgrade your wing, you unlock perks and skills and stuff like that. We can go over here. The way you unlock these things, you can see they have a price. I don't have enough money for any of them, but you get credits for them, I think is what they're called. So, like, let's open up the map here. You can see that this is a green mission. So that means that it's a medical mission, and you'll get medical credits for doing it. And you'll actually get 500 medical wing supplies. Excuse me, they're not called credits, they're called supplies. Let's see, where's another? Right here's a tech mission, and you can see you'll get 700 tech wing supplies for doing this mission. And then as well, there's like encounters, there's medical encounters, there's tech encounters, and there's security encounters, and they're all color coded based on the wings. So you can see that if I did this encounter here, I'd get 60 medical wing supplies. If I did this encounter over here, I'd get 60 security wing supplies, and so on and so forth. Right now we're in Manhattan. This, I guess, would be a good time. There's been a lot of complaints on the internet about the size of the map. At least before the game came out, there was a lot of complaints on the internet about that. But now that the game's out, this is a pretty spacious map. All through here is going to be like your cooperative kind of online modes, and then this red zone here is called the dark zone, and that's PvP. Unfortunately, I'm not high enough level to show off PvP. I just haven't had the time to get that high enough of a level. I'm kind of constrained on time, but if you played the beta and if you've seen the beta, then it's the same exact thing as it was in the beta. But yeah, the map's big because you don't have any cars, you don't have any means of transportation other than your feet. So, yeah, the map's big. It's small, but it's big because you move very slowly. So that's not really an issue. The game actually takes place in Manhattan. currently. But at the beginning of the game, you actually do start in Brooklyn. So I don't know if you ever go back to that or not. But there is another map of Brooklyn as well. So I don't know if you can like fast travel between those two maps or not. I haven't found a way to do it, but it's possible. Let's see. So you upgrade the tech wings to get these perks, which I will go ahead and show those off. Let's see. Where are they at? I don't remember. Oh, yeah, abilities. And you see you have three categories of these abilities that you can get. And then within each three categories, there's three more, like, subcategories, medical, tech, and security. These are your active kind of skills that you can get. You can see I have on Pulse, which will, like, pulsate this wave out and highlight all enemies in the vicinity. And also have on Sticky Bomb, which is like basically a grenade launcher that shoots sticky grenades at people and you can detonate them. But just for the sake of this video, let's put on another one. So, I wonder if I have any more for tech. So, no. So, you would unlock these, like I said before, as you unlock wing upgrades. So, the reason I don't have many for tech is because I don't even have my tech wing upgraded. But you can see I've done the first two upgrades for security and medical. It's at 20% operational, both of them. So I have two skills in each of those subcategories. So let's put on ballistic shield. Whoops. Let's put on ballistic shield and we'll replace our pulsate with that. Okay. So now I've got ballistic shield that we can use. So there's that category. That category is called skills. Then you also have talents, which are also active, or they're not active, they're passive, but they have to be equipped. So right now what I have on is precision, which will make a headshot will make a hostile person pulse for 10 seconds, which I imagine pulse means like stun. I actually don't even understand that one. But for the sake of this video, we'll also replace this one. So let's say this one right here, this will be a passive. Use a med kit during low health to increase damage resistance by 40% for 10 seconds. So you can see I can do that. And you unlock these as you level up. Also, if you get the medical wing 100%. So let's replace this one with critical save. So now, whenever we use a med kit, we'll have damage resistance. 40% less damage resistance, or more damage resistance for 10 seconds. That's this. And again, this is also categorized into three subgroups for your medical, your tech, and your security wing. Then you go over to perks, and these are completely passive. These actually equip themselves. Like, all you have to do is unlock them, and they, as soon as they become unlocked, as soon as you've done the action that unlocks them, so you can see right here, I need to, if I upgrade the virus lab of the medical wing, this will unlock, this protective measures will unlock automatically and go into effect immediately, automatically, without really me even knowing or having to look at it. At least that's been the case with this one, and a few others I've got down through here. But there's quite a bit of these perks. So you can see right now I've got incendiary bullets, special ammo, you know, and a few other ones. That's the main gist of all the abilities here. Let's look around the headquarters real quick. So, in the headquarters here, there's going to be like a few vendors that you can buy from and a few stations you can go to. So, there's these weapon vendors here. You can see you can buy or sell. So, if you went out and, you know, found something, you could sell it here. My wallet is down in the right. And you can see these have values up there. So this is $15. This is $24. And luckily, it's not like this. This is all unequipped stuff. So you don't have to worry about accidentally selling something you've got equipped. And, you know, you can compare it with what you've got equipped to make sure that it's not better, which neither one of these things are better. So let's go ahead and sell this for 15, and we'll sell this for 24. So, you know, this is a pretty standard vendor. You can buy and sell weapons here. You can go to the gear vendors. You can buy and sell. You can actually interchange on the selling. Like, you can sell this gear lady a weapon. You can sell the weapon guy a piece of gear. Doesn't really matter. But this is a lot better than what I've got. We'll buy that in a second after I get done explaining. And then you've also got mods that you can put on your weapons, which I will show you how to do that in just a second. And again, you can also sell anything to this guy. So there's those three vendors. There's this person, which I have no idea what they do. I'm going to be honest. There's a crafting station, which I haven't got a lot into crafting. So you can deconstruct items. And you get like these crafting materials. I assume that's what that stuff is. So, but first, before you can craft anything, you of course have to find the blueprints. And once you find the blueprints, you can craft with materials. So that's pretty much the gist of that. Then there's like all these other people. This is like the she's like the head boss lady. So and then right here's your stash. You can put in goods here. It looks like it can hold. I'm not sure how much it can hold, but let's go ahead and buy this gear. Sure, let's buy this light vest. And you can just press L1, it'll buy and equip it automatically. And now that item that I took off, I could choose to sell it or I could deconstruct it. Let's deconstruct it. So you just hold in L3 to deconstruct something. And you can see I got 2 fabric for that, which I guess I can use to craft. Let's see. Also on weapons, you have 3 weapon slots. This one unlocks at level 4. The second one here. The second primary one. And it's actually really cool. You can mod. If you pick up and find mods, you can mod your gun. So if I go and press square over a gun, you can see that there's a bunch of mods you can put on. There's underbarrel mod, magazine mod, muscle mod, and optic mod. You see I have a vertical grip, a suppressor, and a reflex sight on my AK-47 here. But let's just say I don't want that suppressor anymore. I just go in and unequip it. And you can see you got the three main stats up there are your primary damage per second, your health, and your skill power. Not only do the base stats of all your items affect that, but some items, like maybe this one, yeah, you can see it has like some attributes to it that sometimes help your damage per second or your skill power or something like that. You see the minor attributes here is I get 12% ammo capacity. These blues usually have better ones. Yeah, so see this, I had 140 skill power up there. So the major attributes affect those three main stats that you see up there. And you can go into your character and see how all your stats are a little more in depth. You can also change the appearance with these like light blue things that you find. They change the appearance of some of the items. So let's do that real quick. Why not? Let's go with that one. Let's see what kind of pants. Okay, I got those pants. Yeah, so anyway, you can change your appearance a little bit. And it doesn't matter what items you have on. Those affect all categories. So, that's pretty much the headquarters. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to restart the recording and we'll get into the mission to unlock my tech wing. So I'll be right back after the jump. Alright guys, we're back and we're going to go do this tech wing mission now. So again, I'm just going to open up my map here. And right here it is. So we're going to go to it.
One of my top priorities is securing power. Our best bet for a secure source is a line running through the unfinished.
She's going to say some bullshit. So now what we could actually choose to do is, hold on, I'm gonna let her talk.
Get us that power and recover roads in that order. One's important, the other's vital.
Okay, so let's look at our ballistic shield actually. Why not? Okay, so there's our new ballistic shield that I put on back there in the headquarters. I don't know how to take it off, honestly. Okay, you just throw it away. Sure. I don't want you to think that you have to be in headquarters to put that kind of stuff on. Like, I could open that at any time, and I could change it. I could change it back to the health pulse if I wanted to. But we have the option to walk to this mission and do it ourselves. Or, since this is an online-only game, you can't play this, by the way, if you don't have internet. So, if you don't have internet, just don't even get this game. Also, how are you watching this video? But anyway, we can choose to do that on our own, or I can load up the map here. And this is what I'm going to do. Because not only will it put us in matchmaking, but it will teleport us there. But I can hover over it and can press triangle. And press X, and it'll just start matchmaking for us. And usually I find stuff pretty quick. There's a successful match, and just hold in R3 to join it, and we'll get teleported right to it into an online lobby. So that's the way I've been doing missions, mainly because it teleports you to them. Plus, of course, on top of that, you also get to play with other people. But just because you have more people, it doesn't mean it's easier, because there is pretty noticeable scaling in this game. The enemies do get a little bit tougher whenever you are in a party or a lobby with more than one person. So, also, when we get in, it seems like parties are limited to 3 in this game. At least that's the max I've gotten with some of these missions. So, that's such an interesting choice. Why are games, like, choosing to be 3-player parties? Why 4-player parties was, like, the standard, and now suddenly Destiny and this game all, you know, have 3 people doing a lot of the activities. It's really weird. Okay, so this is the, what is that? What's going on here? This is the one that was in the beta. I know, it's probably really dumb of me to choose the mission that was in the beta and that a lot of you guys have already seen, but regardless, that's the one we're doing. This one does have a kind of a cool boss, so if you haven't seen the beta, the boss will be a surprise to you at least. Looks like these guys have done a lot of stuff. So to activate that special scope I have, I press R3 and you can see it kind of zoom in and out there, activating my scope. I really like the cover controls. It's very fluid. It's got very fluid cover controls in this game. I just like that. Like, I can press and hold X here, just bam, right like that. I really like how fluid the controls are. Combat-wise, you know, this game could be better. It's very bullet spongy. In fact, it's almost turn-based sometimes when you're playing by yourself. You put bullets into a enemy, then you reload, and while you're reloading, they shoot at you, and then you wait on them to reload, and then you shoot at them. And it just goes back and forth like that for quite a while. So that can get interesting when you get into situations like that. But overall, you know, combat and the gameplay's okay, pretty average though. Nothing too special about it. We have intel that there are multiple cleaner teams on site. They're looking to burn out the infection along with anyone who tries to stop them. Be careful. Look at these motherfuckers. Oh my god. Red barrel. Yeah, bitch. Enjoy that. Oh, I'm getting shot. So, when you take damage, you can see I have medical packs that I can use. It's that little cross down there on my HUD. And I have 3. You start out with 2, but you can get upgrades to hold more med packs at once. So, let's take these. So, that was a appearance pair of pants. That wasn't a real pair of pants, so let's put them on. Why not? modern hiking pants.
This project was intended as an extension of the subway system. They didn't get to finish it before the dollar flu hit. Then again, construction in New York always runs on its own schedule.
Activate power relay.
This is actually a pretty easy mission. Some of the missions in this game are quite difficult. I mean, hard as fucking balls. Excuse my language.
Whoever just turned on the lights, you're either JTF or you're really fucking lost. Either way, thanks.
This is Faye Lau patching in. We have help on the way, Rhodes.
Whoever's down here, head for the secondary relay room. And when you see the dead bodies...
So we gotta go get these power relays up, otherwise, just like in the beta. That yellow, I don't know if you saw it, but there's a yellow hit marker, and that just means I'm doing crits. The critical on these guys with the flamethrowers is obviously their flamethrower gas tank. If you hit them just right, you get enough crits on them, they will explode, I think. Of course, in typical video game fashion, the guys with the flamethrowers are explodable. There he goes! Yeah! That guy did it. I gotta be careful to keep an eye on the PlayStation time. Looking into getting an Elgato so I can just record videos, you know, for as long as I want without the software restrictions of the PlayStation.
Activate secondary power relay.
Where are these people at? I don't really like this. The ballistic shield's cool and all, but I miss my pulse because I could find people with it, so I'm gonna put it back on.
This job's gonna take more hands than I've got. You think you can follow directions? Because I'm going to need your help.
Whatever assistance you need, we can handle it.
Good. Because I need some relay boxes swapped out.
You know, this game's kind of grindy. A lot of the missions are kind of like this. You're going to be doing like a lot of missions for other people, like helping them out, in hopes of getting better loot. Like, at the very core of this game is like a loot shooter. And ultimately, the only reason you're playing this game is to get better loot. So, if you don't really care for the grind, I would definitely ignore this game. Because there's a lot of missions like this. Oh, I did it. Hell yeah. A lot of missions where you're just running and doing these little tasks for people. Kind of like an RPG. It can get kind of tedious.
Warning. Hostiles inbound on your position.
Come on, motherfuckers. Excuse my language again. Sorry. I'm trying to cut back on language. Because, you know, trying to sound a little more professional.
Son of a bitch. It's actually working. No more bleeding current into lower Manhattan. A couple more hacks like that.
Again, if the recording stops, don't freak out. Or if you see a cut, you haven't missed much. I'll restart it immediately. You see that? I exploded that cleaner, which is what the guys with the flamethrowers are called, and it hurt the other cleaner. Pretty cool. Leather holster. Sure, it does less damage, but I can always sell it. So these things are scattered about missions, and they're just restock crates. You go up to them, and you get all your shit back.
Warning. Hostiles inbound on your position.
You can see that you have these masks. If I didn't have a mask, or if my meter runs out, you can see my blue meter now that I've got a mask on. I wouldn't be able to enter these contaminated areas. Contaminated areas, if you look on the upper left where my map is, it's this red area. Oh, that's a purple guy. All right, guys, we're back, and I think my teammates were wondering what the hell I was doing because I was just standing there. But we got the recording restarted, and you guys didn't miss anything, so we're still good.
Hostiles inbound on your position.
Oh yeah, this fucking sucks. Oh, damn. Fuck. Okay. Wonder if that guy still got a hold of it. Oh, he does. So we're trying to get these components into these power relays so that we can get this tech wing guy. See my character here that I created.
Activate power relay.
Oh shit, power went off. Okay, there we go.
There we go. Hope you can see in the dark, because I need you in the control room to wrap this thing up.
I wanted my character to look like a crazy psychopath, like someone that had just been waiting for some kind of apocalypse to happen so that they could go batshit crazy. So I gave her a scar and some more paint and a nose ring, because nothing screams crazy more than a nose ring.
Jesus, this thing is loud. Okay, get to work in the control room now.
Character creation, not much to it though. You can like pick the head a little bit. I have a few prefabricated options.
Everything's gonna shut down for a minute.
Not gonna get Sims level character creation in the Division. Maybe we'll get lucky.
What do you know? It's alive.
There's the guy we're gonna get up there. So,
cleaners. I thought you took care of these guys.
Yeah, here come more cleaners, and eventually there's gonna be a boss, so if you haven't played the beta and don't know what's coming up, you're in for a treat. And this is a no respawning zone, so if we all die, we restart here. Recoil in this game is kind of fun to deal with. It's got a lot more recoil than most games do nowadays. Like, if I just let this thing go, you can see it's going up fast. So it's kind of fun. Shooting in this game is kind of fun and rewarding. But for the most part, it's pretty standard combat. The boss is coming up somewhere. Oh, I've leveled up doing this mission. I just realized. Oh shit. Jeez, those guys got wrecked. Let's use my pulse thing. This will be a good time to show that off. So you can see you pulse out and it highlights all the enemies in the area. Of course, it's only useful if you can actually shoot. Okay.
That's more your people in the elevator.
So here comes the boss.
We don't have anyone else on site.
The boss. Name's Belchie, of course. Oh, and he hurts like a bitch. We're wrecking him, though. Oh, shit. One of our teammates is down. They got way too close to him. Come to me! Try to distract him. Hopefully, that other guy will be able to revive. Okay, yeah. Oh, shit. So, see, that right there was kind of cool. When I was talking about the cover earlier, it kept me in cover when I barrel rolled. It didn't that time, but it does most of the time, which is really cool. Okay. Once you get people's shields down, they are nothing to deal with. You can see now he's starting to really pinch off. And I haven't ran into a regenerating shield in this game once, so... Oh, goddamn. And there you go. He dead.
Fucking thing. Jesus.
Alright, that's a wrap. System's clean. Board is green.
You know, loot is color-coded as well, just like, whatever it was we were talking about earlier that's color-coded. White is the most basic. Green's better. Blue's even better. And I don't know if there's something above blue. Alright. Well, that's the end of it. Let's go up this elevator. And we'll have a tech wing when we get back. Okay, so we'll have a tech wing. I'm not sure what perks we'll unlock, but we'll check them out whenever we get there.
Agent, looks like the power grid is a lot more stable. Thanks.
So there you go. Now the mission's complete. Hey, I got a trophy.
So no need to give him an escort. I'll see you when you get here.
You see, we got 700 tech wing supplies. So when we get to back to the headquarters, I'll show you guys how you know, you upgrade your wings. So, you can actually fast travel to the base, which is what I'm going to do. So, let's do that. Looks like my partner there decided to fast travel as well. Alright, so let's go get our tech wing up, see what we get. Now, this is probably going to trigger a cutscene as well. You know, there's not a huge narrative, but there is definitely a story in this game. I would describe it as like a narrative driven by its gameplay, if that makes sense. Where like, the narrative is second to the game itself. This isn't a game that you're going to be playing for its narrative.
Look, I don't do sentimental, but you got me out of a jam there, so thanks. I know you want more from me than just warm fuzzies for saving my sorry ass. Like getting this shithole up to par. Well, government standard, I see. Nice to see they're still keeping the bar low enough that even roaches can walk right over it. You want quality? You go private. That's what I learned in Basra. Oh, yeah. See, you can't just live on farts and good intentions. Power, water, all the bells and whistles. Not that you're the first one to try it. I hear a bunch of you people went missing when the shit hit the fan. Got some theories about that myself. My point is, when you're out there hooking up the city, poke around a bit. See what you can find out. Maybe the virus got him. Maybe the brutes got him. Maybe the city opened up its rotten core and swallowed them whole. I'd believe that. It's happened before. Fucking city got my wife. Miracle I'm still here, really. You know, they say a pessimist is a disillusioned romantic.
This is a very long cutscene, shit.
Whoever said that's a fucking asshole. Go on. See what you can find out. I'll let you know which shit to hook up. Careful this fucking city doesn't eat you, too.
So yeah, like I was saying, the narrative's not really anything special. To be honest with you, I haven't even hardly been paying attention to it. But anyway, regardless, let's get this tech wing up. So the way you get your tech wing up is you just purchase your first upgrade. And for some reason, it gives you this tutorial about the wing upgrades every single time you unlock a wing. So, and it always makes you do the first upgrade. So, whatever. That's how you upgrade. And I just spent 500 supplies on a control room. And so that unlocks some new abilities, it says. Let's see, what abilities it unlock? I got a turret and also got a perk, which allows me to increase my inventory by 10 slots. I might get that. So let's see what else. We can do central heating, which would give me complete a cover move. Okay. Just looking at what I can get here. Let's do this. I like that. Reduce damage by 30% there. Yeah, let's do that. So there we go. Now we've got our tech wing up to 20%. And we unlock two new talents and a perk. So let's see what we got.
You just made my Tinkerheart real happy. Designated area for repairing, repurposing, refurbishing gear.
Oh, okay.
You can go crazy in there, Agent. About time. Now we got a proper control room.
Ah, I see. So
monitor the infrastructure, heat, water, electricity.
Okay, I got it. Fuck off, Paul. Shit. Where's that recalibration table at? Right here. I see. This is like if you want a different attribute on your armor, you can change that here, it looks like. So, let's see what new perks we got. Let's see, we got a turret. Sure, let's go ahead and put that on. We got two new talents, but we have no more slots, so we'll have to... During a cover move, incoming damage is reduced by 30%. Yeah, I want that one. Okay. And we also got two new perks. So, see, it just automatically did that. I can just carry 10 more slots now. It should be 42 in my backpack now. And it also did this right here, which will unlock an item stat switching at the recalibration station. So, let's see if I can actually still hold 32 things. Or 42. Yep. 44 items I can hold now. So, yeah, definitely it does that without even you having to do anything. So, let's sell some of the shit we got. Well, let's make sure none of it's better first. So, yeah, none of the stuff we got's better than this AK. None of the stuff's better than my Police M4 either. And I didn't even get a better holster. So, I didn't get anything from that mission, so I'm going to sell it off.
Step right up and take a look.
Yep, sell. Sale. There needs to be a sell all button. There is a sell junk button, but I don't think that would sell some of this stuff. Okay. Let's put that suppressor on my Police M4. Whoops. Alright, and I'm going to restart the recording real quick. Alright guys, we're back. We have pretty much showed you all pretty much the main basics. Like I say, most of the game revolves around these three wings. At least so far the game's been revolving around these three wings. And everything you get from upgrading those wings. You can see it looks like there's 10 apiece. So I don't want to say that's the whole game, but it could be. I'm kind of bummed out I can't show you guys the Dark Zone. But basically, that's the same thing you've been seeing. It's just kind of PvP sometimes. That is where the better loot is, though. So you'll definitely want to do the Dark Zone as often as possible if you want to get better loot. But before we go here, we'll do one of the side missions. Let's see how many medical wing supplies I've got. I'm thinking about doing a medical wing encounter. So let's see here. How many supplies do I have currently? I only have 120. If I did one, I'd get up to 180. So that's too bad, man. But anyway, I want to get this medical wing going. So let's go do this medical wing encounter out here. Now for these, I don't believe you can matchmake because they're basically just little side missions. So we will have to run to it. So let's go. You can actually see I'm still in my... This one guy is actually still in here with me from where I match made earlier. I don't really know how to leave these things other than just logging out. So I don't know. I'm sure there's a way to leave, but whenever I match make, I just stay in there with the people until I go on to the next mission. So yeah, this is 0.5 kilometers away. That's actually quite a distance in this game. So you'll get a little idea of how big the map is. Whoops. That is something I get confused about. The controls are pretty fluid, but for some reason I can't get it out of my head that X is how you jump over things, and it's actually circle in this game. Awesome. I've aggroed someone. Hey, what's up? Crap. So, along the way to encounters, you're going to run into stuff like this. Some of these fucking dickheads around. So I don't think I have... No, I've got a turret now, so... Throw out the turret and try it out. Fuck. Okay. So yeah, it looks like it hurts them and it distracts them, so that turret's kind of good. They know they fucked with the wrong one. I'm a division agent, bitch. Okay. None of them dropped any loot, unfortunately, but that's okay. You see over in the right, you get a little XP bonus for some challenges like headshots and, you know, taking damage and staying alive and killing people after you've taken damage. Graphically, this game looks alright. I've definitely seen better. Definitely the first time they showed the E3... God, I can't talk today. The first time they showed the E3 trailer, the game looked a lot better back then than it does now. You know, take that as you will. I'm not really overly critical of game companies for doing that, but the final game still looks pretty good overall. Definitely runs at a pretty solid frame rate. I've only had a frame rate hiccup once, and it was because I was looking at like 10 of those cleaner guys shooting fire, so it's kind of a slightly understandable reason for the frame rate to take a dip. But overall, runs great, and it looks pretty good. So I'm pretty happy with the graphics. Is bad guys? Nope. So, yeah, that was about 0.5 kilometers what we just went there. So you can see... The map's pretty good size. It takes a while to travel, so it makes it feel like it's bigger than it is. Anyway, let's do this encounter. These are just like little side missions, so shouldn't take too long.
Heads up, agent. I've got something important for you.
You are now entering a safe area.
Yay. It looks like this was hardly anything. This is just a safe area. So safe areas are kind of like little mini headquarters. They'll have vendors and restocking stations and shit like that. Plus, obviously, it's safe. So that's all I had to do for that encounter was go here. You can see there's some other players in these safe houses. I haven't encountered other players, like other than people in my party, in the actual world. It looks like the only place you can see other players... are in these safe houses, and yeah, you can. That person just disappeared when they ran out. But, yeah, you know, these are like, they have your stash in here in these safe houses, and you can restock. So basically just a little mini headquarters. Since that was such a disappointing side mission, we'll do another one. Let's see. Let's do this other medical one here. Maybe we'll get enough to upgrade my medical wing one more time before I finally call it quits on this video. Wow, this is 7 kilometers away, or 0.7 kilometers away. Is there one any closer? Doesn't look like it. Oh, what is this right here? That's probably not closer, but whatever. We'll do it. I think this is a virus research. Which if it is what I think it is, we're gonna have to like find these little machines scattered across an area and activate them. So, wants me to go this way. Now it wants me to go this way. I hate when games do that, man. You start to go one way and the waypoint tells you to go the other way you're heading. Then you start to go that way and it tells you to go back the way you're heading. It's fucking dumb. There's some kind of fundamental bug in these waypoint systems of video games that needs to be worked out. I don't want to go to that phone recording. I hope it's not got me marked for that now. Huh. That encounter disappeared, so let's go to this one. Not sure why it did that. You can kill the animals. I know I'm a terrible person, but, you know, if you want to kill animals, you can definitely do that. For the sake of this video, I wish the fucking map wasn't so slow to navigate. Fuck! What's up, y'all? Oh! Hey, he dropped some loot. Let's see what it is. It's nothing any better, but again, I can always sell it. Fuck. I don't want to keep running into these bad guys. They slow me down. These guys are level 5s. You take a lot more damage than you give, it seems. Which can kind of get annoying, but I'm just going to run away from this guy. Fuck him. Is he following me, really? Alright, let's try to get these last little bits of medical credits, medical supplies, whatever. What's up, bitches? So let's try to do this virus research here. I gotta somehow get in. Oh, I might not be able to do this. It said required filter 2. I don't know if I have that. No. Damn.
Contaminated supplies detected.
Well, I was hoping that I could do that final medical encounter, but, I guess I can't. I'm gonna have to call it quits on this video, though, because, running pretty long now. It's basically been an hour of me playing The Division, so, yeah, that's The Division. I like it overall for the most part. There's a few things. I think the gameplay can be a little boring sometimes. Like I said, the enemies are kind of bullet spongy and combat can get old. Like I say, when you're playing by yourself, it can be almost turn-based slow combat. It's kind of crazy. To me, the grind is fun in it. Like, I kind of enjoy that aspect of it. I kind of like games where you just shoot shit and get better loot, so that kind of is fun. You know, the narrative is lacking. There's not a lot of narrative, but this isn't really a game you'd expect to have a lot of narrative. And the controls are pretty good. That's pretty much all I wanted to say about The Division. And when I say controls are good, I mean the cover system's really good. Really a well thought out and executed cover system. But that's The Division. You know, if you like a lot of grind, then go ahead and get it. If you really don't. Anyway, that's going to do it for this video, and I will see you guys next time.